show that 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 7 and so on up to nth terms is equals to n by 2n plus 1. Let S of n be the given statement, which is 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 by 1 by 5 into 7 and so on up to n terms is equals to n by 2n plus 1. So first we have to find the nth term, because nth term is not given directly here. So the numerator is 1 in all the terms. In denominator we have two series, the series of first terms, which is 1, 3 and 5 and so on, and the series of second terms is 3, 5 and 7. So first series is in the form of arithmetic progression. So 1, 3, 5 with the first term A and the common difference 2 between each term. So the nth term of AB is A plus N minus 1 into D. So 1 plus N minus 1 into 2. So that can be written as 2 N minus 1. And the second term's series is 3, 5, 7 and so on up to 11. So here the first term is 3 and the common difference is same 2. So A plus N minus 1 into D means 3 plus N minus 1 into 2. So simplifying this, we can write 2 N plus 1. So the nth term will be 1 by 2 N minus 1 into 2 N plus 1. So now we will prove that S of 1 is true. So for that LHS of S of N, so we have to substitute the value of 1 in place of N in the nth term. So 1 by 2 into 1 minus 1 into 2 into 1 plus 1. So that can be written as 1 by 2 minus 1 into 1 by 2 plus 1. So 1 by 1 into 3 is 1 by 3. Now RHS. To get the RHS, so we have to substitute the value of 1 in place of n in the RHS of the given statement, which is n by 2 n plus 1. So 1 by 2 into 1 plus 1, that is 1 by 3. So now LHS is equals to RHS. Therefore S of 1 is true. Now let us assume that S of n is true for n is equals to k. So we will write the given equation with n is equals to k. So 1 into 1 by 3, 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 7 and so on up to kth term, which is 1 by 2k minus 1 into 2k plus 1 is equals to k by 2k plus 1. Now we have to prove that S of n is true for n is equals to k plus 1. For that we have to add the k plus 1th term on both sides of the equation. So we will find the k plus 1th term by substituting k plus 1 in place of the k plus 1th term of the equation. This is the kth term 1 by 2k minus 1 into 2k plus 1. So writing k plus 1 in place of k, we will get 1 by 2 into k plus 1 minus 1 into 2 into k plus 1 plus 1. Expanding this, 2k plus 2 minus 1 can be written as 2k plus 1, and this can be written as 2k plus 2 plus 1 can be written as 2k plus 3. So adding k plus 1th term, which is 1 by 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3 on both sides of the equation, we will get till here the equation is same. We are just adding the k plus 1th term on both sides. So taking the RHS, k by 2k plus 1 plus 1 by 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3. So in this term and this term, if we observe in the denominators, we have 2k plus 1. Here 2k plus 3 is there. If we multiply the numerator and denominator of the first term with 2k plus 3, we will have the same denominator. So writing this in the single denominator, we can write it as k into 2k plus 3 plus 1 by 2k plus 3 into k 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3. So multiply this here, k into 2k is 2k square plus 3k plus 1. 2k square plus 3k plus 1. Simplifying this 2k square plus 3k plus 1 by factorization method, by splitting the middle term, we have 2k square plus 2k plus 1. 2k square plus 2k plus k plus 1. So in the first two terms, we have 2k common. So we can write it as 2k into k plus 1 plus k plus 1. So further we can simplify this as k plus 1 into 2k plus 1. So in place of numerator, we can write k plus 1 into 2k plus 1. So cancel this 2k plus 1 and 2k plus 1. We have k plus 1 by 2k plus 3. Further, we can write this k plus 1 by 2k plus 3 can be written as 2k plus 2 plus 1. In the first two terms of the denominator, we have 2 common. So it can be written as k plus 1 by k plus 1 plus 1. Comparing this with the RHS of the given equation, so in place of n we have k plus 1. therefore s of k plus 1 is true. Therefore, by the principle of mathematical induction, s of n is true for all natural numbers.